Are you thinking of getting a dog? If you are, do you think you're ready for it? Hello everybody, welcome to our channel. I am Angie and this is Wally and Zazu. And today I am going to discuss 5 questions you should ask yourself before getting a dog. Number 1, are you committed? So dogs are a big and long-term commitment. Their average lifespan is about 10 to 13 years, and dogs are very dependent on you. So it is very important to love and take care of them at every phase of their life, not only when they are young and healthy, but also when they get older and require extra love and attention. One of the biggest responsibilities as a dog owner is to properly train your dog. Firstly, whichever puppy or dog you bring home, there is certainly going to be a lot of adjustment. It is basically an adjustment period where you need to train your dog, so be prepared and be patient with them. Proper training is a must for a happy dog because a happy dog would mean a happy you. So it can be a challenge with some, but patience and persistence is always key. Number 2, do you have the time? Dogs require regular exercise or they can cause a lot of trouble out of sheer frustration. Specifically with bigger dogs like Zazu and Wally, they need to be mentally and physically stimulated very regularly. Therefore, we dedicate 2 hours a day just for the boys. So me and Daddy share these responsibilities. We either walk, run, bike, hike with the dogs 1 hour in the morning and 1 hour in the afternoon or evening, rain or shine. Also, socializing your dogs with other dogs and other humans is very important. For instance, we take them out to the dog park where they get to interact with other dogs. We also take them to social events where it is dog friendly. They get to meet our friends, interact with other humans. So it is very important because it shapes their personality as well as how they are in a very social environment. Number 3, are you ready financially? So owning a dog can be very expensive. Some of the expenses you need to think about is food for the dogs, medication, vaccination. It is necessary that all vaccinations are up to date for the safety of your dog as well as others. Some of the medication like flea and tick prevention as well as HeartGuard is very highly recommended for dogs. And most importantly, a very good dog insurance. So Zazu and Wally have gotten sick a handful of times ever since we've had them, and without a good dog insurance, it would be very difficult for us to manage all of those expenses. Because one thing I've learned is dogs don't speak, so they can't say what is wrong with them. So basically, we have to rule out all the possible health conditions, and let me tell you, watching a dog in distress is definitely one of the most helpless feelings I've felt. Number 4, do you have a good support system? It is also very important to have a good support system for your dogs and yourself. Either family or friends that you can depend on, who can take care of your dog and also who your dog is comfortable with. For example, when me and my husband go on a long vacation or there are times when we can't be there for the dogs, it is always our support system, which is our family, our friends, who step in and help us with the dogs, and we are so grateful for that. Number 5, and the most important question to ask, is if you are mentally and emotionally ready. A dog can change your life tremendously. You need to make sure you are ready for that change. Like I said, there is always an adjustment period when you bring a dog into your life. Things change, and it is very important to ask yourself, are you ready for that change? There will be a lot of instances where your priorities might change. For instance, we can't leave the dogs alone for long periods of time, so we cut down on going out for late nights and stuff. We work our schedules around the dogs. Also, we don't take long vacations because we don't want to be away from the dogs for a long period of time. So just things like that. So during puppy stages with Zazu and Wally, mostly Wally, I used to have literal emotional breakdowns because it was so hard to crate train him. And I just used to get really frustrated. But eventually we all learn and adjust with the new normal. But you need to be prepared for all of that. Therefore, you need to ask yourself if you are emotionally and mentally ready for a dog. If I could take you up in boom, boom, boosh, boom, boom, tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Sweetheart.